Good morning students, welcome to day 18. In today's class we are going to discuss the next disorders, that is Mendelian disorders. Which one? That is hemophilia and color blindness, and both are that is X-linked recessive disorders. Now coming to the third disorder, okay, that is the third one here, sickle cell anemia. This disorder discovered by scientist Herrick, okay, that is in 1910. Scientist Herrick in 1910. Now, what is the cause or symptoms of this disorder? It is a autosomal recessive disorder. Autosomal andre endre sex chromosome ge sambandhilladu. Okay. It is present, the gene which is responsible for this disorder is found on, that is the autosomes, means body chromosomes. It means one in the 22 pairing irthore body chromosome ant helthivi. So this gene is present on again 11th chromosome, and hence it is called autosomal recessive disorder. Okay. I will write here first point. It is a type of autosomal recessive disorder in humans where a gene responsible for, or the gene which codes for, responsible for, you know already genes produce, that is a transcription and translation, protein produce material, and that protein acts as enzyme, isn't it? So where a gene responsible for the synthesis of hemoglobin, actually that is beta globulin chain of hemoglobin. Yav chain called akta idu illi, beta globulin chain, alpha and beta, there are four chains in the hemoglobin, that is two alpha chains and two beta chains. Beta chain do, that is a globin protein entry, that is beta polypeptide entry. Other all changes are, A change are to known, right? It is an example for point mutation. Okay, now, synthesis of hemoglobin is found on, that gene found on chromosome 11 is defective, andre endre mutated, defective and produce abnormal hemoglobin. Sentence after Malgori, it is a type of autosomal recessive disorder. It is the gene which is present on autosome. 11th chromosome by autosome. Okay. Autosome. Now, disorder in humans where a gene responsible for the synthesis of hemoglobin. Normally hemoglobin is called, but exactly beta chain. Even second point I will tell. Okay. And the gene is found on chromosome 11 is defective, mutated irtudu, alteration agirtudu, and produce abnormal hemoglobin. Normal hemoglobin tayar madodilla, synthesis madodilla. Okay. Now I will write here the clear information about this one. Sickle cell anemia, it is a point mutation. You know point mutation, what it is? Previous classes are already known. That is a change in the single base pair. And this example is also seen in molecular basis of inheritance chapter. That is one. So it is a point mutation in which point mutation in a gene ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಬಹುದು ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಮ್ಯೂಟೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಜೀನ್ ದಟ್ ಎನ್ಕೋಡ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಕೋಡ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಮೋಗ್ಲೋಬಿನ್ where the sixth, very important it is, the sixth codon, a gene valaga, sixth codon, you know, one protein there are like 20 codons, make a triplet codons, and 20 codon in the 20 amino acids join at the one protein there after that. Here that protein is globin protein in the hemoglobin. Hemoglobin daga naal chain adu, that is 2 alpha and 2 beta. Beta chain olaga, okay, that is in one chain, what happens here? The codon which is producing that globin protein, adolaga RNA codon irutide, the sixth codon by name, that is GAG. GAG codes for glutamic acid is replaced by, this codon is replaced by GUG. Only A change aagta idiri, A jagada en bartha idu, instead of A U is replaced by here, and now GUG will code for, which codes for valine. Now this codon will code for what? Valine. And here the structure of hemoglobin chain changes. Let us see. After diagram it will be clear again. Now listen. There are three possible genotypes in the individuals, okay, homozygous, okay, and heterozygous, like that, dominant homozygous, heterozygous, homozygous dominant, heterozygous dominant, and recessive to homozygous, that is three genotypes are there. There are three genotypes possible, okay, possible genotypes. First, here remember it is again a single pair of allele, means gene. The gene is HBA. This is first. These individuals are normal. If this is irregular, sickle cell anemia, and this is irregular, because it is a normal healthy hemoglobin chain. AA, it is represented as. Second genotype ಏನೈತೆ, HBS. Now these are affected. Yes, under sickle cell anemia. Affected individuals and die in the childhood only. Okay. Childhood. Because the problem in actuary, due to the sickle shaped RBCs of the blood, hemoglobin and the RBCs. These RBCs are not able to carry the blood properly. Amount of oxygen in these RBCs is not carried properly, and such individuals suffer from, that is, suffocation problem. That is, oxygen less in the body, and they die. That is good. Now, third case, heterozygous case. What is that? HBA, HBS. Now, listen, it is a recessive disorder, autosomal recessive disorder. So, this person is, that is, alive or normal, but it is a carrier for this disease. Okay, but now remember what happens in this case, the third case, heterozygous case. I will write here, the heterozygous individuals nothing but HBA, HBS. Okay, HBA, HBS. You know, These are the alleles. Alternative form of only one gene. Which gene? The gene which is responsible for the formation of globin protein. Found on chromosome level. But other allele actually alternative hang irthavari HBA, HBA irthava. But yes, bandandre enadari that is affected, mutated gene it is allele. So one is from mother in this individual, one is from father, for example. So such individuals, the heterozygous individuals have both, I will write here, have both normal and sickle cell hemoglobin. Hemoglobin in their RBC. In their RBCs. Okay. Now, what happens under normal conditions? I will continue here. Under normal conditions, there is these individuals, their RBCs are circular and normal. Normally RBC sanctuary, that is biconcave like, circular and normal under normal conditions. But I will write here, but under oxygen tension, under less oxygen tension, tension means that is amount, okay, percentage in the atmosphere, but under less oxygen condition or tension, condition given here, tension means amount of oxygen is less, tension means that proportion, okay. So but under less oxygen tension, the mutant, very important, the mutant hemoglobin andre yavudu HBS, this one, the mutant hemoglobin changes from biconcave disc shape to elongated disc like structure, disc like structure or sickle shaped structure, sickle shaped structure. Hence this disorder called sickle shaped sickle cell anemia. Now listen, important, just here to concentrate in the heterozygous. The heterozygous individuals means genotype in other yavudu HBA, HBS. Now this gene is coming on 11th chromosome from father or mother. Ikade inon 11th chromosome bartudhi gamete olaga. This is one from father, this one gene on 11th chromosome from father, this one gene on 11th chromosome from mother. Now these are homologous genes, okay, because they are present on homologous chromosome. Yav pairing, 11th pair, okay. Now the normal one from the father and the mutant, this is sickle shaped one, hemoglobin, that is from mother. Okay, now the heterozygous individuals means that is genotype, have both normal and sickle cell hemoglobin. Actually both, that is one. Normal one hang irthu, only normal RBCs irthava, sickle shaped irang illa, like hemoglobin in their RBCs. Again, under normal conditions, their RBCs are circular and normal. Avarige enu problem irangilla. Normal condition andre enu, sufficient oxygen iddaga at the lower altitude area on the ground surface of your body. Okay. But under less oxygen tension, the mutant hemoglobin, idu avaga summa irangilla. Okay. It will perform normal. But the mutant hemoglobin, that is HBS, changes from RBC shape in irthudre actually. ಇದು ಯಾವ ಆರ್ಬಿಸಿ ಇದು ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಇದು ಹಿಮೋಗ್ಲೋಬಿನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಿರ್ತದೆ ಅಬ್ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಹಿಮೋಗ್ಲೋಬಿನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಿರ್ತದ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ದ ಶೇಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಸಿಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ವಾಟ್ biconcave disc shaped RBCs converted to that is elongated disc like structures. That is one. Elongated and angry. I will show you. For example, this is RBC shape. It will convert into like this. Book pada kotta nodri NCERT page number 89. Okay, please observe the book every time like that. Now it will become like this or like this ether after. Okay. Now after this, what happens? Now idu admantre enartha nodu. These elongated or sickle shaped RBCs fails to pass through the narrow blood capillaries, isn't it? Blood capillary in the flow of the okay. I will write here. Yauri elongated. These under low oxygen tension is the problem of you. These elongated or sickle shaped RBCs fails to pass through narrow blood capillaries. Narrow blood capillaries and hence block the blood flow. Block the blood flow. For example, this is the capillary. It is normal RBC to move up to. But when the RBC converted to this sickle shape type structure, when here the veins are like this or capillaries like this, at the corner or at the bend area, that is they may block at the corner and due to which the flow of the blood is stopped because your shape in I3 vaga, it is the length of the RBC increases than the diameter of this capillary, isn't it? So hingagi enagtare ilbandi ee tara. Okay, they here block here and hence the flow of the blood will not be normal, it will be blocked and hence the person die. Such individuals die in such conditions. HBS condition dagantu idu normally aagthadi childhood age death aagthada, but HBS condition olage en aagthada, the elongated or that is sickle shaped capillary RBCs, they fails to pass through the narrow capillaries because there is diameter is very narrow in the capillaries, so blood and the flow agle beku every part olaga body olaga, so these fails to pass through the narrow blood capillaries and hence block the blood flow. Okay, the person die. Soon the individual die, may die like. So this is the case here. Okay, now after this, such individuals, the heterozygous individuals are resistant to, very important point, are resistant to malarial parasites. Ivarige malaria agodilla because malarial parasite that remains in the RBCs. Here size of the RBC is reduced and hence their parasite life cycle cannot be completed and hence they are not going to sustain or survive in the body of such individuals. HBA, HBS, heterozygous. Okay, and hence these are resistant to malarial parasite, also known as, this is asked the question in the NEET exam, less prone to or not prone, suitable under. Okay, not prone to malaria. Inon point enantandra, such individuals who have that problem of suffocation due to this disease, sickle shaped disease, okay, these individuals not to go to or warned to not to go at high altitude area. Altitude area, because there is less oxygen tension, high altitude area, hilly areas, all these things like that. Okay, so there is less oxygen tension, and when there is less oxygen tension, our body will again act the other. The mutant HbS hemoglobin in act the, it changes the shape of RBC from biconcave to elongated type, and then blood capillaries are blocked and the person die. And hence such individuals are warned, that is, they don't have to go to the altitude area. That is the warning for them, precaution for them. Plus point is that here, what is the benefit? They are resistant to malaria. That's all. It is a benefit, because any malarial parasite of body will sustain avodilla. That is all. Okay. Just see the structure, how it changes. 9L is second point. It is a point mutation in a gene which codes for the hemoglobin, that is at the sixth position, GAG. Okay. Yavari codon adu? GAG. Okay. For example, this is on mRNA, 5 prime to 3 prime. This is mRNA. It is otherwise synthesized by transcription. Transcription CTC. Now, what is this? This is our template strand. Transcription unit neck mark, trans molecular base affinity receptor 3 prime to 5 prime. If the opposite character is complementary strand, coding and theatrical. That is GAG. This, which strand it is? Coding strand. But during transcription, only one strand will act as template. Our standard name is template adjectivity, aqua non coding adjectivity. Okay, coding strand in the mRNA care of the non coding, which has polarity 3 to 5 prime. That is one. Either male grade RNA polymerase in the mRNA synthesis martha code. This code, it will code for what? Which amino acid? Sixth codon it is on mRNA. It will code for glutamic acid. Sixth it is. For example, I will write here the diagram given in book. Valine, okay, histidine, and then leucine, and then threonine, fourth. And the fifth is 309. Fifth in the diagram. Let us see this. For example, I will write, just forgot here. Something it is at the fifth one. Sixth area, glutamic acid. Now this is sixth codon, and seventh is also glutamic. Seventh is also glutamic. This is first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and seventh. Now sixth, GAG, A not to relay. Now listen, this is about DNA strand. Okay, DNA in the end there, are mRNA, this process we call transcription. Idu cytoplasm da hogi enagutla, cytoplasm amino acid change aagutla, this process is called translation. Now this is a chain for what? Normal hemoglobin. Normal hemoglobin means HbA, healthy hemoglobin. Okay, now here, what happens here in case of this mutated, A not really, GAG, just A is replaced by U. I will write here GUG, same diagram given in the NCRT. Now this is transcribed from template strand C T C. Here T means DNA वाला thymine birth उधर. Okay. Now this is again template strand which is having polarity 5 to 3. Template, and then इकड़े coding इतुरी इलेम बर्थ का G A G. This is a coding strand in the DNA. Now, in the gene, GAG. Now listen. CTC. Here, U in the sense, for example, here, A, and here in the T after you. GTG. Just change after the DNA. If the DNA will change, it will change. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಎಂಆರ್ಎನ್ಎ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನ್ ಬರ್ತದ್ರಿ ಯು ಬರ್ತದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಟಿ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಎ ಬಂದಿತ್ತು ನೌ ಬಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಬಂತ್ರಿ ಯು ಬಂತು ನೌ ದಿಸ್ ಜಿ ಯು ಜಿ ವಿಲ್ ಕೋಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ ವ್ಯಾಲಿನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲಿನ್ ಓಕೆ ಉಳಿದೆಲ್ಲ ಸೇಮ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಏನಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಇದು ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲಿನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟಿಡಿನ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಲಿಯೋಸಿನ್ And fourth, that is threonine. And fifth, it is, I think, proline. It is, yes, proline it is. Okay. I will correct here also. It is proline. Now, sixth one, actually, here it is glutamic acid, GAG. But it will code for, now GUG. U change again. It will code for what? Valine. Again, the seventh will be same. But remember, due to only this change, this is a point mutation, the shape of the RBC changes. That is equal shape up to it. It is which type of RBC? Sickle shaped RBC. Nothing but, I will write here HBS. This book will apply to this diagram is very important. Okay. Now, totally this is about sickle cell anemia. This disease is caused due to that is autosomal recessive gene. Autosomal activity 11th chromosome the gene I think. Our gene A martada, beta globulin change pair martada. But when this gene is defected, mutation adaga, it will not produce the normal hemoglobin and due to which that is oxygen holding capacity of RBC is reduced and hence the person suffer from this disorder. Three types of genotypes are possible. HbA, HbA, that is normal. Our here disease are healthy persons. Okay. HbA, HbA genotype. HbA, HbS, they are carrier, but they are high altitude area of the problem. And HbS, HbS, they are nothing but fully affected sickle cell anemic patients and they are going to die in the childhood only. So this is about total. Sickle cell anemia. ಇದರೊಳಗೆ ಕೂಡ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್ ಕೇಳಬಹುದು ನಿಮಗೆ ಕೇಸ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್ ಅಂತ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಎ ಸಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯರ್ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾರೇಜ್ ಟು ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಅನೇಮಿಯಾ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ಸ್ ಆ ತರ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಎಚ್ ಬಿ ಎ HBS. Now she is carrier married to normal man. That is HBA, HBA. Okay. Now what is the proportion here? Chances? It is autosomal. Now listen. Is it right to go in green? For us, I will write direct. HBA from the father, HBA from mother. Okay. Now again, this HBA. From father, but this HBS from mother. Now this person will become carrier. Okay. Male, female, after the one. Again, same in case from father HBA, from mother HBA. From father HBA, from mother HBS. Means 50% offsprings are carrier, 50% are normal. It will change not to both of you. It will not to be able Because they die in their childhood. Okay, innon sadhe enaitri. Suppose this is also a carrier. Ava ee total change aagutte. So that type questions may be asked again. Okay, so after sickle cell anemia, we will move to next disorder. That is by name phenylketonuria. Theory olaga 1-2 marks kelabodri, but entrance olaga very important. Okay, phenylketonuria. Fourth disorder फिनाइल कीटोन यूरिया. लिसन ओके, दैट इज डिस्कवर्ड बाय साइंटिस्ट फॉलिंग 1934. दैट इज फॉलिंग ओके. व्हाट इज दिस नाउ लिसन हियर. नम बॉडी ಒಳಗ ಫಿನೈಲ್ ಅಲನೈಲ್ ಅಂತ ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಇರ್ತದ್ರಿ. ಆ ಫಿನೈಲ್ ಅಲನೈಲ್ ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಮೆಟಾಬಾಲೈಸ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊರಿ. ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊರಿ. ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಸಮ್ ಅನ್ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಫಿನೈಲ್ ಅಲನೈಲ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಓಕೆ. ಫಿನೈಲ್ ಪೈರುವಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಓಕೆ. ಫಿನೈಲ್ ಅಲನೈಲ್ ಇಫ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಓಕೆ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ವಿಚ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಫಿನೈಲ್ ಪೈರುವಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಡೆರಿವೇಟಿವ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಅದು ಸಪೋಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊರಿ, ಟೈರೋಸಿನ್ ಒಳಗ ಈ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಲಿಸನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಮೇಜರ್ ಡಿಸಾರ್ಡರ್ ಓಕೆ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಸ್ಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಲಿವರ್ ಬ್ಲೀಡಿಂಗ್. ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಸಾರ್ಡರ್ ಕಾಸ್ಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಆಟೋಸೋಮಲ್, ಅಗೇನ್ ಆಟೋಸೋಮಲ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಟೋಸೋಮಲ್ ರಿಸೆಸಿವ್ ಜೀನ್ located on, that is chromosome 12. chromosome 12 ಇದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಕ್ರೋಮೋಸೋಮ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಓಕೆ. ಕ್ರೋಮೋಸೋಮ್ 12 ಅಂಡ್ ಆ ಜೀನ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದ್ರಿ, ದಟ್ ಜೀನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಒನ್ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್. ಐ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ದಟ್ ಜೀನ್ ಫೇಲ್ಸ್ to code for an enzyme, enzyme name is very important, phenyl hydroxy phosphorylase okay. Sorry, phenyl hydroxy hydroxylase, phenyl hydroxy hydroxylase enzyme. It is produced by which gene? The gene which is autosomal recessive found on chromosome 12. ಈ ಜೀನ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಡಿಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಿರ್ತದ, ಮ್ಯೂಟೇಷನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಿರ್ತದ, ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ಲಿಸನ್, ಇಟ್ ಫೇಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕೋಡ್ ಎನ್ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ ಫಿನೈಲ್ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಸೈಲೇಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ದಿಸ್ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಫಿನೈಲ್ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಸೈಲೇಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ. This enzyme is required to convert which amino acid? Amino acid phenylalanine, phenylalanine to tyrosine. Question yaha karna kya bolri? Phenylalanine to tyrosine. Okay. This enzyme is required to convert which amino acid? Phenylalanine amino acid to tyrosine. But ilena agta ide enzyme tayar agta illa because gene enagidre mutation agidala okay. But that is in absence of this enzyme the phenylalanine accumulated जमा आगतवी हंगे बॉडी ओळग अक्युमुलेटेड एंड कन्वर्टेड टू फिनाइल पाइरुविक एसिड. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, फिनाइल पाइरुविक एसिड एंड इट्स डेरिवेटिव्स, एसिड्स एंड डेरिवेटिव्स, दैट इज वन. नाउ एन आगत नोड्री, the accumulation, ಇದು ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಟ್ ಆದಾಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ನೋಡಿ, ದ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಿನೈಲ್ ಪೈರುವಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್, ಇಟ್ ಲೀಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ರಿಟಾರ್ಡೇಷನ್. ಪ್ಲಿಯೋಟ್ರಾಪಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಏನ್ರಿ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಅನಿಮಿಯಾ, ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಚ್ ಸಿಂಥೇಸಿಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪೀ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಿನೈಲ್ ಕೀಟೋನ್ಯೂರಿಯಾ, ಮೂರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಿ. ಅದರೊಳಗೆ ಇವನ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಟಮ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ಸಿ, ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ರಿಟಾರ್ಡೇಷನ್, ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ of hair and that is pigmentation, skin pigmentation aakunu theli. Like that, the accumulation of this means phenyl pyruvic, phenyl pyruvic acid in brain causes what? Mental retardation, comma, reduction of hairs proper growth irangilla, and then pigmentation theory, eczema. This is very important. This is again word eczema, nothing but what? Itchy skin. Okay, now this is also characterized by the hypopigmentation of skin. Skin oda pigmentation kadima agide. Hypo means yes, low. That's all. Hypopigmentation of skin. That's all. Clear enough idea here? Due to that accumulation yak aagta ide, convert yak aagta illa. This phenyl and tyrosine block convert aagta illa. Yak aagta illa ri? That is due to this abnormal gene, defect gene. This is in liver in case. Okay, this enzyme produced in liver. That is okay. Now listen. Due to this function, which is not going to complete, that is phenylalanine is not converted to tyrosine. In after it, phenylalanine accumulate and converted into phenyl pyruvic acid and derivatives. And after its accumulation in the body, okay, or in the brain. Phenyl pyruvic acid accumulation in the brain aadaga mental retardation aaguthada, that is one. Reduction of hairs, eczema, the disease aaguthada, that is itchy skin. And also this disease is characterized by what? Another symptom, hypopigmentation of skin. Remember, one gene is controlling here many characters, showing many characters, nothing but again it is example for pleiotropy. Okay, now here this phenyl pyruvic acid is also excreted through urine and hence this disease is called phenyl ketonuria. Urea, that is in the urine. Phenyl ketonuria. So this is again very important. 2 marks kelabodu athwa entrance exam oda yen kelabodri. The gene fails to produce which enzyme? Phenyl hydroxy. That is hydroxylase enzyme. Okay, and that enzyme required for what? Conversion of phenylalanine amino acid to tyrosine. In absence of this enzyme, what happens? Phenylalanine accumulate and get converted to which form? Idu kuda question kelabodu. Phenylalanine pyruvic acid derivatives. Okay, then and it is continuously accumulate aagi enaagutadri, accumulated in the brain. Then it is accumulated in the brain olagaaga through the blood olagi jaasti aagutada and brain kade ade blood hogta irutha, body wala circulate aagta irutha, and hence it causes mental retardation and these all symptoms, diseases. Now, and due to more accumulation in the body, it is also excreted through urine, and hence the disease also known as phenyl ketonuria. Very important is autosomal recessive disorder again. After this, another disorder given in the book, thalassemia. Yellow color, yellow. Last page, because in NCERT it is mentioned, that is, please also see last pages, that is 289, I think it is 289 page number. Thalassemia disorder. 5th disorder, thalassemia, discovered by scientist Cooley. Now we listen in pretty interesting. Scientist Cooley. Now what is this? Okay. It is an autosomal recessive blood disorder. Again it is blood disorder. Sickle cell anemia also related to blood. Okay. Now it is a, I will write here. It is a autosomal recessive blood disorder. Autosomal recessive blood disorder. Okay. Caused due to excessive, Henry means more, excessive degradation of or degeneration of, degradation of RBCs. Very good. RBCs. Okay. Due to less hemoglobin synthesis. Hemoglobin synthesis. Remember, thalassemia. Okay, it is again an autosomal recessive gene responsible for this one. Okay, now here the gene which is responsible for formation of what? That is hemoglobin. Okay. Now, a hemoglobin yakara tayar aagtadi, less amount, abnormal antilla. Sickle cell anemia da yen bandittu, abnormal antu bandittu. Here, now this gene is going to produce less amount, sufficient in reading. Less amount of hemoglobin is going to produce. Okay, now, here, normally, or normal persons, normally, hemoglobin have four chains. Yav yavri? 2 alpha, and it is 2 beta. 2 beta, isn't it? Now, what happens here? Due to less hemoglobin formation, because gene and every mutation I due to less hemoglobin, due to less hemoglobin formation, the these under 4 chains, these chain formation is affected, these chain formation is affected. It means hemoglobin particular one proper amount tayar aagila antelukori chain kuda tayar aagudilla. Okay, chain formation is affected and the individual and thus the individual suffer from anemia. Very important. That is, characteristic feature of this disorder is anemia. Characteristic feature of thalassemia disorder is anemia. The person or the individual suffer from anemia. Elena Kudri, the gene which is responsible for the formation of hemoglobin, again, it will produce less amount of hemoglobin. And less amount of hemoglobin agitka inaktada, it will affect the formation of, that is, 4 chains, 2 alpha, 2 beta. A chain proper tayar agudilla. And hangagi blood formation complete irodilla body olaga, and hence this individual suffer from anemia. That is why. Now, thalassemia have two types. Again, important is inventory, that is thalassemia A. I am writing in short thalassemia B. Thalassemia A and thalassemia B. Eastern entry. That is the types of thalassemia. Another point I will mention here. Remember, this question is already asked in NEET, I think 2017 or 18 example. Okay. Now, thalassemia is what happens? Hemoglobin is ready. Less hemoglobin is ready. Okay. Thalassemia, I will write here, that is, what is hemoglobin produced? Less hemoglobin. Either easy argument will be thalassemia equal to what? Less hemoglobin form in the body. Sickle cell anemia, hemoglobin is produced, but it is abnormal hemoglobin. Abnormal hemoglobin, isn't it? And hence, these two differ from each other. If a question kya kar, these two disorders which are related to blood only and even autosomal recessive erdu kuda, but they differ from each other. Thalassemia or less hemoglobin aagtade, hence thalassemia is considered as quantitative problem. Quantity and really amount, less amount, quantitative problem. Yav disease re thalassemia. Abnormal hemoglobin in the sense qualitative. Hemoglobin is formed, but that hemoglobin is not proper quality. It is not having a proper quality. It is abnormal. Okay. Normal tara irrelevant. And hence, sickle cell anemia is called qualitative. Quality saragilla. Qualitative problem. Thalassemia is quantitative problem because less hemoglobin produced, but less hemoglobin, but correct hemoglobin. Normal irtho. Abnormal irrelevant. SCA, sickle cell anemia, sarcastic to the hemoglobin, but it is abnormal. Okay. Hence, quality saragiral. That is called qualitative problem. And thus, these two differ from each other. These two means thalassemia and sickle cell anemia. These two differ from each other. Clear? Okay. Now, after this, another example given in NCERT, that is cystic fibrosis and the word has been mentioned matter yavru, but other bagge even normal information kodtina. Okay, now cystic fibrosis, sixth disorder, anemia is the symptom for thalassemia. Okay. Sixth disorder, cystic fibrosis. Okay, now eastern entry. It is called due to the autosomal gene found on the chromosome number 7. Okay, caused due to autosomal recessive gene found on chromosome 7. Symptom length period. Okay. Now, thick mucus formed in lungs. Thick mucus formed in lungs. Again, it is in detail. Okay. The first abnormality starts in the pancreas. And due to this, again in the lungs as well as in the skin, okay, that is thick mucus layers are found in the lungs and salty sweating occurs in the individual. You cannot see symptoms other, but in listed NPD, cystic fibrosis, it means symptoms in NPD, thick mucus layer formed in the lungs. Okay, that is one. So this is about total Mendelian disorders, nothing but the disorders which are caused due to the single gene mutation. And after this, there is a second type of genetic disorder, that is chromosomal disorder. Okay. And I told in the beginning, that is genetic disorders are put into two categories. That is, one is Mendelian disorder and under which these six examples are completed. And the second type is chromosomal disorder, that we will continue in the next class. Okay, please watch these videos carefully. If any doubt, ask the doubt in the college application. Okay, so in the next class we will continue with chromosomal disorder. Till then, read well. Thank you.